Hello everyone, Mike here from DB Services, and today we're going to be looking at our demo file for the FileMaker IoT integration. It's a pretty simple demo file. You can take a look at it. You can get our demo files that are used in this video. It also includes the Node.js code that I'm going to show you later that we're uploading. On the left side, we've just got a machine status. The idea is in the warehouse, whether you're tracking machine status or an inventory amount for a particular item, you would be able to set the button out there, let a worker hit it, and it would immediately notify you on the dashboard. You could also get more complex and integrate it with a vendor's ordering system to immediately reorder stock or, you know, notify someone else. You could pretty much do anything you could normally do with FileMaker with it, so it's pretty powerful. On the right-hand side, I've got my button counter. You can see I've hit the single click 40 times, double click 30, and the long click 10 times. That's just a tracker for every time I hit the button, it's going to increment it. Next, we're going to show you how to create the Lambda function within Amazon AWS Cloud. Lambda is a microprocessor that lets you run as needed, so it kind of spins up its own little mini server as needed. The function here, I'm just going to call it my function. We're using Node to write it. And we're going to use a role from a template, and down here we're just looking for the function name again, and down here we're looking for the basic Lambda. It's going to go ahead and create the function for us. Once the function's in there and created, we just need to upload our zip file that has the code. Like I said, that'll be inside the demo file, and then define our parameters that are used inside the file. So these are called environment variables. Inside here, we can go ahead and upload our zip file, Lambda source code, and down here we need to define our variables. So we have the server, the database, and the layout within the database we're using, the username, for this demo it's just username admin, password admin. I do not suggest you use those in a live development. Script name here is just button push, and we are good to go. So what I'm going to do here is tell this to save, and once that's done, let's go ahead and upload and save. Over on the left-hand side, we need to add a trigger. And the trigger in this case is my Amazon button. I've got my serial number here. I'm going to go ahead and add it and save my changes. The nice thing about using the template is Amazon automatically configured it to its CloudWatch, so everything would be logged from the button clicks. Next thing we need to do is configure the button. And I've got this preset up on my phone. So I've got my cell phone here. You can see my buttons already listed there under the AWS IoT buttons. I click it. I click the middle one for the Lambda functions. And inside my existing functions, you can see the function we just made. So I go ahead and change the action. And just like that, my button's now configured to talk with our database. Now, sorry for the poor video quality, but I'm going to come over here and hit this button. It's going to flash blue for a while it's making the connection, and then it goes green, meaning it succeeded. Lastly here, now you can see that our button clicks went from 40 to 41. I'll do that again, only this time I'll double click it. And you'll see the double increment, 34, and there we go. As simple as that. Now the real beauty of this is being able to use FileMaker's coding to do whatever you would like with it. So in this case, it's just creating a new record in the dashboard and doing something like, you know, setting the supplies based on the single, double, or long button click. But really, the world is your oyster in this situation. You can do anything you'd like with this. That's kind of the power and the beauty of FileMaker, being able to integrate with anything you'd like. Well, if you have any questions, don't hesitate to reach out to us. And we are here for your help. I hope you enjoyed it, and come back next time.